Everybody has this problem in their flower beds, and that's something you might call cocoa, you might call it nut grass, but it's actually a sedge. This is purple nut sedge, which has a purple seed head, and yellow nut sedge, which has a yellow seed head. Purple nut sedge is the number one ranked weed problem in the world. It's not a surprise why you have it in your flower bed. Yellow nut sedge is the 16th ranked weed problem in the world. They actually rank weed problems. So the big problem, though, are the tubers that this plant produces. The plant produces lots of tubers, thousands of tubers in a landscape bed. When you hand remove this plant, you leave tubers in the soil, and the tuber that you leave in the soil will produce a shoot. Within about 100 days, it can produce 300 tubers. So the growth and the number of tubers produced are astronomical. Now, hand removal is not a great option for controlling it. In some countries, they actually consume the nut sedge tubers. Purple nut sedge is kind of bitter, and yellow nut sedge actually tastes like almonds, but so do almonds. So you're not likely going to consume it. So there are some spray options that you can use in your landscape beds. Organic products don't seem to work that well. They just seem to burn the tops. We have this product that contains sulfentrazone that's a ready-to-use product that's pretty good. And we have Image Nut Sedge Killer, which contains imazoquin. That's also pretty good. But my favorite probably is the most aptly named, and that's Sedge Hammer. And that contains the active ingredient halosulfuron. It's very effective at killing the emerged sedges. But this is the number one weed problem in the world. You'll kill a few of these sedges, but a million will come to the funeral. You're going to have to make several applications to rid your flower beds of purple and yellow nut sedge. So there are some spray options available at retail nurseries, but with all of these products, you need to read and follow the label directions. Forget it growing. This is Ron Strahan with the LSU Ag Center.